Now returning to BBC Two for a new series, staunch anti-drug campaigner James Hellyer takes up the challenge to spend a week living with the enemy.
The use of cannabis is wrong. I believe that all recreational drugs should remain illegal.
We're the Exodus Collective and we campaign for the immediate legalisation of cannabis. There's millions of people who make a sensible choice of drug use because it relaxes them, because they enjoy the social atmosphere that it creates, they enjoy the sharing activity that goes with it.
It's my belief that those who take drugs become fit only for their own company. After all, no one wants to spend hours on end with someone whose sole line of conversation is, whoa, heavy.
As part of our campaign for a sane drugs policy, we challenge the criminalisation of cannabis by openly smoking and openly growing our own weed.
The laws against cannabis should be fully enforced, including mandatory minimum sentences for possession.
The whole idea of putting someone in prison because of a choice to smoke cannabis is an insult to and an abuse of the whole idea of prison.
You have people who'd say you can't lock all these people up, there aren't enough prison cells. Well, then build some.
Has Manor, on the outskirts of Luton, home to the Exodus Collective. James Hellyer, former chair of the Cambridge University Conservative Association, has been invited to live with Exodus for 1 week. Exodus claim that cannabis aids communication, heightens awareness, and enhances community life. James's host for the week is Exodus spokesman Glenn Jenkins. Both are eager to put their views to the test.
Finally made it.
Well done.
Nice to meet you, James.
Nice to meet you.
Lovely to meet you, James. Lovely to meet you, mate.
Nice to meet you, John.
James.
Right.
Hello.
Fine, thanks.
Hello, James.
Hi. Arms.
All right. You get to know the names of the windows.
You're the first one you'll remember.
Thank you.
Yeah, this used to be a hospital, and we squatted it in 1993. Yeah,
and we've been here ever since.
Well, we're licensed now. You'll be glad to hear. It's all licensed and legal. We'll get on well with the people for sure. You know. Yeah, there's too many of them not to, they're all friendly, you know what I mean? So he must be someone he likes, isn't it?
Well, it's reassuring to know there's little chance of being lynched by an angry mob.
Oh, no chance, no. We think you're going to enjoy it. Have a good time.
Well, that remains to be seen.
Exodus are proud of the alternative lifestyle they've created. On a tour of the manor, Glenn and Bouncer explain their philosophy of community living.
Has manor is a living example of do it ourselves by using existing resources and everybody's energies combined. We've changed this place from what was a derelict empty shell into homes and work for everybody who lives here, and we intend to share that experience with James by putting him into what was a totally derelict empty room and converting it with a hands-on help over 1 day.
And this, James, is your home for the next few days. And what happens is the whole collective have got different talents, and they'll help you decorate and equip this from things which are donated to you. Everybody will get hands in on help.
On first impressions, the people I've met here seem to be very nice. Some, I hesitate to use the word odd, but I will, seem a little bit odd, strange, or unusual. I've never met people like this before, and certainly never lived anywhere like this. not at all like the university halls of residence or the family home, in fact.
We're still getting our head around it, thinking, blimey, we've got the chairman of the Young Conservatives, Christ College, Cambridge, reading the Telegraph and the Mail, playing classical music in the pottery room at Hazmat.
Evening barbecue provides the setting for the first skirmish in the drugs debate.
You notice the most people smoking here and there.
Well, pretty continually in some cases.
Well, one of the only drug problems we seem to really have is keep running out.
It can't be that continual.
I was thinking of challenging either you or Bouncer to give up smoking cannabis for the rest of the week.
Yeah, that's a good one. I was Bouncer.
And they say it isn't addictive.
Why would you want us to do that?
It's an interesting experiment, shall we call it?
James has raised a point, right? Someone here take a week off the herbs. That is a challenge. I was saying to James, it's like you go to your pub, right? And you drink beer, you drink Abbott or something. You go to the pub, they ain't got no Abbott. That's, you like Abbott, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Right, and you're gutted, there ain't no Abbott. But you ain't going to start going like, give me some Abbott kind of thing, you know what I mean? It's along that level, right? But he's made an interesting point saying, he said, that's what you're saying, but prove it.
And no problem.
No trouble. Not a worry at all, no
We've
shaking.
We've got a candidate for your week off over here, mate.
Okay.
James Boswell famously said in his introduction to his and Dr. Johnson's tour of the Western Islands and the Outer Hebrides that they were thinking of seizing the opportunity to go to a strange, savage and different land near to their own and perhaps experience a little danger. I must admit that my feelings coming here were rather similar to that.
Everyone felt a bit protective towards him because he was obviously one amongst many, and you know, that imbalance gives him a little advantage in a way, if you like, because people feel protective.
I've challenged them to find someone who will give up smoking cannabis for the rest of this week.
Oh yeah, I think his idea about taking time out from smoking ganja sort of defeats the point a bit.
But it will be interesting to see if, first of all, whoever says they're going to do it sticks to their resolution, and secondly, what effects there are. One shall see.
I really can't see the point in that.
But I understand that Bouncer might be rising to the challenge.
The next morning, Glenn takes James on a guided tour of an Exodus project. They plan to convert an empty factory into a community centre for the nearby Marsh Farm estate. Outside, a small group of local residents have turned up to voice their concerns. Glenn goes out to face them.
I think we're against you. We're not against you, we're against the Exodus. You're the spokesman. You got more name on your newspaper for troublemaker than anybody else in this country, in Marsh Farm. People, they've been to your raves. I know people, they've been to your raves. Exodus raves. And then been told if they wanted drugs while they were... I know that, it's fact.
Well, look, you could go to any place in this country.
No, forget the place in the country. We're talking about...
And people get drugs.
We're talking about the Exodus.
Mean Exodus.
No, we're talking about the Exodus now. Forget about the people in the country.
What you're saying is that although these people would go and get drugs anyway, in Exodus you've got a community, if you like, centred around drugs. Lots of people taking drugs, and you don't want them moving here into the heart of your community because of that.
No, we've got the school across the road, you've got shopping centre over there, you've got houses around here. We got better off for as is in Marsh Farm as is.
So you're worried that your children might be tempted by them
into
taking drugs?
Of course they'll be tempted. Are they going to make money if they don't sell drugs? You're telling me. By selling Coca-Cola, Orange 20...
I'm pissed off with James, to be honest with you. I was pissed off with James. I was pissed off with James, right? Because it was like, this is an important community issue, this. It's a really seriously important issue. And James should at least trouble himself to find out details behind it.